intimate, yeah?
What's up, everybody? My name is Leihua, and welcome to the Superfina channel. I am a Hawaii variety content creator, host the podcast Across Worlds, and I stream on twitch.tv/LeihuaSuperfina. Today, we are reacting to Ascendance of a Bookworm. And if you like anime reactions, don't forget to subscribe, ring the bell so you can be notified on the next upload. And if you'd like to support the channel, we got channel membership, Patreon, and merchandise. Link to those are below. We are reacting to Ascendance of a Bookworm, episode 31. Season 3, episode 5. Myne and her companions were attacked. Is this the Dark God, they said? And those are... Were they farmers that went to attack the carriage? Oh, they weren't farmers from the area, but they were still farmers, right? Connections in different domains. God of darkness, not the dark god. God of darkness. Are they like giving us hints to find like a traitor amongst people we know? Sense of mana. Devouring soldiers? Like how Myne had the devouring? Soldiers? Wait, I saw people! What? The gift from the blue robe priest and going home. Ooh, which blue robe priest? Which one? But doesn't devouring soldiers sound like zombies or something like that? I'm just saying. Oh, this place has like its own structure. I didn't realize even the temple area has like a structure within this area. Farmers are more important? Ooh. They are putting her up on the pedestal. Livened up the kitchen a bit. Cute. Sylvester, what up, you? Here to try some more cooking. His guide for what? Yeah, for what exactly? Orphanage and the workshop. Everything she's involved with? He sounds a lot older than before. He sounds more mature. Is it just my imagination? You knew you'd have to see them one day? Wait, you haven't seen them yet? Hello? It's been, like, what, a year? Yes, it's very organized. Ooh, be brave, girl. Be brave. You can do it. Good job. Oh, he praised you. They are not for sale, so I ain't reporting them.
Hey,
She made them so people can learn how to read! Learn the alphabet. Trapped indoors during winter. Ooh, after winter, now they can read and write. Yes, head priest. He seems he has a lot to say! Oh, is this going to get bigger than we thought it was? Toys seem more interesting and profitable. He's finally encountering the Myne. More apprentices, yeah. Oh, that's too close, too close, that's too close. Personal space. Oh gosh, Benno, you hang in there. Oh, that's why he was looking at him so intently. It's the food. He wants to cook. The new printing press. Press nut. Ooh, I like seeing the process. She's like, isn't it amazing? Oh, he has a mountain of questions. Fran should be giving him reports? Is she like, oh, I thought you already knew about this stuff. Oh! 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 What's going on? What happened? How is it all her fault? Yeah, what did she do? Yeah, can you like elaborate? But do your best. He's like so frustrated. Did Sylvester get that? Maybe he does like kids. And he wants them to cook it too. I bet that's why he wants them to cook it. What's that? Yeah, what is it used for? Protective charm when you need it. Oh, you're gonna put it on for her? No, she has not. She's just a little kid. That's kind of intimate, yeah? This is not a pairing, right? Fury and Trevor, press your blood seal upon this stone. Ooh, he seems so gallant with that. She has all kinds of adults around her. She's got Ferdinand, who's like kind of uptight, but also looking out for her. He gets stressed about her. And then you get Benno, who enjoys her innovations, but he gets stressed about her too. And you have Sylvester, who's like taking the opportunity to enjoy life. It takes the hard work of many workshops to make one page. But that's not the case with your book. Everything can be done in one workshop. Yeah. Oh, he's asking how the world changed when farmers were able to read and write. Incite their people. Yeah, because there's mana in this world, and that adds value to people. See, there you go, the magic. Oh, what do you mean? Is magic running out? The way he uses the word grand. Don't print for a while. Copying books? Oh, he's trying to prevent the grudges. Yeah, how long should she wait? Oh, until she is a noble herself. If you're a high class noble who received permission from the Lord, you will not be crushed easily. Stop the printing for 2 years? Oh man, she'll be making all kinds of products in those 2 years. No, she wants to spend time with her family. I mean, she's getting a younger sibling. Mm-hmm, treasure her current family. You have opened her eyes. You caused that. Mm-hmm, that's why your hands are tied. Make a few children's books here and there. I guess nobles won't care about children's books, that's why. They're related, aren't they? He's related to Lord Sylvester, huh? Oh, what? Are you getting defensive?
Don't need to get defensive.
Oh, you're not done. I thought you were. Eh? She can go home, see her family, touch her sibling in the belly. Oh, she's so happy. Is that the first time he's ever seen them interact? You're gonna pop any second. They kicked me. She's like, they kicked me. I hope the mom doesn't have any difficulties while giving birth. Hee hee hoo! I did not hee hee hoo when I gave birth. I just breathed. I breathed like how I worked out. Holding a celebration. Why won't you tell Delia about this? It's a boy! I like how both Myne and her dad are similar. Yeah, what's his name? Camille? Oh, he has blue hair! The baby's not comfortable in her little arms. Baby's like, not comfy! Aww, making books for her younger sibling will be her motivation now. Move much more elegantly. Where is Lady Christine? Oh, is this girl not allowed to dance? Oh, she looks resentful. Ooh, a pedophile. Oh, she just sold her. And the boss's mistress! Oh, girl, she knows about that. Oh. Looking for a child with a devouring?
Yeah, we have a noble that's looking for a child with the devouring. Someone that was like mine. And in the beginning of this episode, we were talking about devouring soldiers. I think they're connected. I think this noble here is looking for devouring children. Children with the devouring to make them into soldiers. But when will this be revealed? Will Dahlia uncover this mystery, this secret, this scheme, and be able to help Myne and the others with this? You know, unveil this conspiracy? Huh, very interesting. Very interesting that Ferdinand told her to not make any more books until she becomes a noble, until she's adopted. But she can still make children's books. So I'm assuming this whole season is going to cover the 2 years. And I'm assuming at the end of this season, she's going to be adopted and become a noble. Huh, interesting. And I'm wondering if she's going to get connected with all the other workshops that were making books. That way, they don't go out of business. Because, you know, they're people in her class, right? Like, she's got to help them out. I wonder if she's going to make, like, a book guild. You know how there's, like, an ink guild? What if it's going to be a book? And it's going to be, like, a umbrella branching off to all these other guilds. You know what I mean? That'll be interesting. Mm-hmm. And that part with Sylvester giving her a necklace, that could totally be seen that they're trying to ship them together, how they're going to, like, get together towards the end. But then they also kind of, like, show that there's potential between her and Ferdinand. But, there's just too many options for her. And the reason why she said she has so many options is because it's culture, because there's no boundaries with age. Like, you can be super young and be with, like, an older guy, because when you get old enough, you can be with that person. And your age eligibility is not that far from what I could see. I mean, Dahlia, she's, like, already trying to find out who she could be someone's mistress. You know? It's like, ugh, this is pretty nuts. And it's interesting how Rosina's old friend, who was a dancer, is with the high priest. And it seems like she's not allowed to dance. And she's more like being used for other activities. And so she's resentful. She's very resentful. But what happened to Lady Christina then? Huh? Where'd she go? She just left her attendants, her people, her gray robe people. Where'd she go? What happened? Did she get married? Like, did she get called away? Because there's not many nobles, priest nobles, for a reason, right? So, very interesting. I wonder if we're going to get more world building. I think we will. I'm excited. Well, besides what I'm talking about, let me know what you guys thought about this episode in the comments below. And if you want to talk outside of YouTube, there's a Discord. Link is in the description. I also stream on twitch.tv/LehuaSuperFina. Outside of YouTube and Twitch, I host podcasts across worlds where we talk about anime, manga, and other things we're interested in. If you like podcasts like that, link to podcasts is in the description. We're available on all platforms. Other than that, my name is Lehua, and this is the SuperFina channel reacting to Ascendance of a Bookworm, Episode 31, Season 3, Episode 5. Hope you guys like this video, and we'll see you on the next one. Laters!